Hello and welcome to my new growing area in my back garden. It's right behind me now. It's in my back garden between my apple tree, which is behind me here, and if I go this way, my greenhouse is there. So it's that area. As you can see, it's full sun, which is really, really good for a growing area. And I'm going to be growing in this area things like lettuces and cut and come again crops and herbs and things like that. I want to have two raised beds and I want to have a little seating area, a little bistro table. That's all I've got in my head at the moment. So what I need to do with this area is I need to clear it first of all so that I can sort of see the wood for the trees. This area has become a bit of an overgrown mess. Nothing really grows here, which is why I wanted to use raised beds. I say nothing grows here, but as you can see, the verbena is self-seeded and it has gone absolutely mad this year. But I do find this a hard area. We've got quite heavy clay here and this area doesn't drain very well. I've had a lot of issues with this area in the garden, which is why I want to change it up. I want to have an area that I can come and cut things that I use every day, things like lettuces, like I say, and salad crops. And I just want to really revamp it so that it's a usable space. So as you can see, like I said, the verbena has self-sown. There is a globe artichoke in here, which is looking really, really good, but it's right at the back and it's sort of falling over now, actually. I've got some geums, some sedums, and some veronica and some other bits and pieces in here, which I do want to keep, and I will be removing from this area and just putting into pots for now that I can move at a later date to somewhere else in the garden. I do want to keep the guelder roses at the back of the border. So I want to keep them as sort of like a hedge at the back. And then when I want to have my two raised beds, my little bistro area, and I want to have some sort of gravel at the bottom of that to make it a really nice usable area. The first things first, before I do anything else, we need to get this area cleared. I'm thinking the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the verbena, I'm going to cut all of them down first of all, and I'm going to use them in my house. I'm going to put them in a vase. I'm also going to cut the globe artichokes down. I'm going to dry them because I've seen people do that, so I'm going to try and dry them. And then I'm just going to start cutting back and removing anything that doesn't need to be moved first of all. So any weeds and anything that is overgrowing. I think I've got a bit of work on my hands, but I'm excited. Found some chives under here, so I definitely want to keep those because I can actually use those in the new beds that I'll be putting in. So I'm going to dig things like this up. The borage, I was just trying to see what I actually had in here, and it's all just self-seeded, so I am going to be covering it and putting gravel down, but I want to try and get as much up as I possibly can rather than sort of covering it. So I'm going to keep things like this. And the rest of it I'm going to try and pull up, or at least get to sort of ground level as much as I can. Okay, so right here I've got things that I want to keep. So I've got some hardy geraniums here. So I want to keep those. I'm going to try and keep these lilies. So I'm going to dig them up. And I've got these veronicas. So what I've tried to do, which I haven't done very well, is try to keep something so that I can see where the plant is, so that I can dig up that perennial. So I'm trying to do it as best as I can. Sort of keep the iris. I've got an iris here. So I definitely want to dig that up, but the rest of it I'm just trying to clear so I can sort of see the area a bit more. Okay, so the first sort of stage is done, where I've dug up everything that just needed to come out and I've pulled that up. what I need to do is now move the things I want to keep. The ground's really hard and you can't really dig it as such. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to wait till a bit later when the sun's not as bright. It's the middle of the day at the moment. I'm going to give it a really good water, let it sink in, and then I'm going to dig everything out. Okay, so it's a bit later in the day, the sun is going down, it's a bit more shaded down here. So like I say, this area does get full sun, but towards the end of the evening, it just starts to get a little bit shaded, just this side of the greenhouse, and then it moves over. So I've given that a bit of water. What I'm going to do while I'm waiting for that to sink in a bit, I'm just going to tackle this area here. This area I know has got nothing in it. This is all just self-sown verbena and bindweed. The difference on this bit is actually crazy. Like, it's just unbelievable how much. I mean, this is a mound, an absolute mound. If I do that, you can see how tall it is. And that was all just here. But I'm just going to show you how bad the soil actually is. So this just shows you these big cracks in the soil. We've got such heavy clay. And it just dries literally like stone in the summer, and then in winter there's just absolutely no drainage. So I really think this is going to make this area so much more usable. So now I'm going to dig up everything that I want to keep from this area. I've dug up a geum, I've dug up some veronica and my chives. I have actually got some iris in there, but I think I want to move them to an area somewhere else in my garden, and I need to do a bit of work there. So I'm not going to do that this second, but that's the only thing left in there to move now, is just the iris. So you have to crack a few eggs if you want to make an omelette, is that the saying? So it looks a bit of a mess right now. We've got this pile of weeds and brambles and everything else here. Everything just looks a mess around here. But I can see the woods for the trees now. So I can see at the back, I have got my hedge of guelderose. So I think there's four there actually. But they were being so crowded out by all the weeds that I think only this one's really been doing anything. So hopefully they'll do a bit better now anyway. This here is a bird feeder, a stone bird feeder, a stone garden ornament, I'd say. We actually got that for free. Someone was giving it away. I don't know if I'm going to keep it in this area or not, but at the moment it's fine there. I can't move it anyway, so I think it's just going to have to stay there for the time being until I work out what to do. But I have got two raised beds, so I need to work out now. Am I going to have them sort of like two here and then a nice seating area here with my bistro table? Or should I have some other sort of layout? Should I have a raised bed here and a raised bed here and then my table in the middle? What are your ideas? What would you do with this area? I definitely, because of the soil that I've got, I definitely want to cover it all with a gravel, like a really big gravel. You see that little bird? That was a little robin, I think, just came down. So obviously there's a lot of bare soil now, so it can probably see some little insects it wants to eat. So let me know what you would do. Let me know in the comments any ideas you've got. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.